Hello, hello everyone. How are we feeling today? A bit more relaxing. Enlisted, methinks. Nice rotation, probably some more Lord of the Rings tomorrow then, seeing as we've got a day off from the D&D. I could swear today was Thursday, but it's not. It's not Thursday. I've been told it's not Thursday by people I trust to be able to read a calendar. So there you go. We're going to do America today, because we've done Germany, we've done Japan. That only leaves the Soviets and the Americans left, so I think a little bit of hamburger today. A little bit of hamburger. Then maybe starvation next time. Let's see, we've got 9 people online, do we? Okay. We'll try to... What, how many people can you have? You can have 3 people on your team, can you? Okay. We'll try to rotate out a little bit. I need a system to pick people. That's what I need. Let's see, we'll keep it about tier... Yeah, tier 3 sounds about right, because that way we can kind of go up and down a little bit, depending on... granted, my ally tier 3 is kind of shit, but tier 3 will work, more or less. Let's see, we'll just close our eyes and go up and down on the list for a little bit. There we go. 1... Save. Oh, no. 2. 3. There you go. And we'll give them a little while, see if they accept. My natural inclination towards stopping at the midpoint prevents me from doing it properly. I am, as always, as in all things, centrist. Too long. I am a harsh master. Let's see. Draconis, I see him in chat. To the 2 bottom ones, then. Listen, you've got like 10 seconds. Well, there you go, Zinkoi. And Draconis. Draconis, I see you in chat, you little shit. Hey, well, no. 10 seconds. Five. little Draconis. Kick Draconis. Right. I'll go at the top of the list this time then. Gosh, why is nobody ready? I expect you to sit there attentively, like loyal little hounds. Oh, there we go. Okay, we have a group. Yay. Off we go. Is there anything I'm supposed to be doing today? Kill 20 enemies using special weapons. Okay, well, battle rating 5. I see. Zinkoi. Battle rating 5. Okay, well, I'm just gonna go with it this once. I'll try to keep it around 3. But a little bit of suffering has never hurt anyone, right? Yes, it is. It's available. It's on PC. You don't need a console for it. In fact, I believe they were working on a Steam release. I'm fairly sure. I'm pretty sure there was an announcement a little while ago that they were doing a Steam release workup for it. Which will be nice. I mean, God, this is one of those games that's just in beta for seemingly forever, right? Like they've still got the little splash screen. There we go. At the beginning, where they go like, hey, this is still in a beta. Not everything's gonna work yet. So don't criticize us. Listen, bitch. Your store functions... Your store functions well enough to do, like, discounts and shit on it, right? I think your game is done at that point. The moment you add in a store functionality to your game and start charging for microtransactions, I don't think you should be allowed to call yourself a beta anymore. Like, we should actually... we need some more rules and regulations on this, okay? We need to be, basically, okay, if you release a game and you are charging money for that video game, then get fucked. It's released. Now you must abide by basic standards of a release product. That's how it should be. You should not be allowed to monetize a beta. And hey, it's fine to do like an early access, like long-term release. That's okay. But you've then got to make that clear. Like, this is like an early access sort of deal, right? It's like, okay, we intend to add a lot more to this game. Why is it like? Am I downloading anymore? My Little Pony pornography in the background? I'm not. Weird. Normally I would be, of course. So you could still release a game and have it be continuously developed, but you need to actually tell people that and be like, okay, this is how this is going to work out, right? And if people don't want to pay you for a, you know, beta, essentially. You have failed me today, Mr. Thompson. You have failed me most dreadfully. Jesus. Come on, Mr. Thompson. Thank you. God damn it, Mr. Thompson. Hi. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, do I have a... No. I was thinking, do I have a hand grenade I can drop on him? No, sadly not. Die, little flamethrower boy. Ow. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. And go. That didn't kill anybody, which makes me a little bit sad. Get stuck. Hi. Ooh, that looks way more useful than what I've got. Thank you. Now run to cover. That is way more powerful from what I got. Yeah. Sounds more powerful, too. Right, sadly, it doesn't have a whole lot of ammunition, but I appreciate it whilst I have it. Oh, hi. Yep. I saw that one zip past my fucking head and figured to myself, there's probably somebody shooting at me, but I reacted more quickly than I did. They've buffed the AI again. I'm interested in... Alright, nothing particularly unusual about that. I'm interested in seeing how the new AI reacts. Because apparently they made them even better now, which is cute. Mm-hmm. This is a like AI-focused game in that regard, of course, so that's fine and dandy. Let me see. Let me just try and get him. Is that a motherfucking mouse? Or is that just a KT? No, that's a motherfucking mouse, isn't it? No, it's a King Tiger. It's a Porsche Tiger. Right. How the fuck am I supposed to aim this? It's a very good question. Oh, hey, that works. Sorta. Alright, I gently tickled him. I have no idea where my now nose is. Alright, that works. Oh shit, okay. Turning. He does a wide turn inside me. Yep. Fair enough. We'll just roll on top of him, and I still don't know where my fucking nose is! Now, let's not put our flaps to take off. That seems silly. I still don't know where my fucking nose is. There's my nose. More or less. And if I had any idea what I was pointing, I'm pretty sure I would have had him there. Luckily, this guy is a big fan of the very long and slow and relaxed turns. Not something I would normally recommend in a dogfight, but hey, some people seem to really enjoy it. Right, two down. Not too bad for not having the faintest fucking clue where I'm pointing my aircraft. I am wondering what they see when I'm doing this. Like, what is happening on their screen exactly? Do they just see a dude flying through the air? Well, apparently he can see me. Do they just see a dude? Or do they actually, like, see me, I wonder? I'm kind of... Is that a biplane? Yeah, that's a biplane. Okay. Sure, why not? Right, I did get a hole in me engine there, which has caused me to leak a bit of fuel coolant. Which isn't necessarily catastrophically bad just yet. I can keep a control of that. Right. I mean, this aircraft is going to go down in the relatively near future regardless, because I'm not going to be able to keep the engines cooled, but I can keep it up and about for a little while longer.
Need enemy vehicle coordinates.
Anybody know where enemy tank is? There you go. Lovely. And is that an enemy aircraft as well? I wonder no longer. I know. Guten Tag, mein Freund. Well, that was very lucky. I was about to say, his ass is gone. I'm pretty sure I can just peel off now, and I was about to, until apparently the fact that I don't have an aircraft makes me very vulnerable to 20mm ass gunner fire. Who'd have thunk? Oh well. I do wonder what that looks like to other people. Because if it just looks like a dude, then that's actually kind of OP, because if somebody's trying to kill me... Oh, hello there, paratroopers. Are those? Oh, they're friendly paratroopers. Never mind. Apologies for the, you know, hand grenade and stuff. Because if all they see is a dude flying by the literal seats of his pants, in this case... then that probably would be really, really annoying to fight against.
All right, at any cost, hold that position.
Explodey things. I mean, it's not great being the person who flies with the invisible aircraft. Because again, being able to tell which way your aircraft is actually pointing is a pretty fucking important part of... Hi there. I thought that was a German, that was a bush. Germans and bushes are not the same thing. Why should I go out there? Why should I go out there? I should just sit here and camp like the fat little bastard I am. I was about to say a naughty word there. Let's not. Right, whilst we're sitting here, I suppose I might as well get a little bit of use out of my engineer. Here you go, fellow hamburger aficionados. Cover! Cover is great. It provides something to put in between you and enemy bullets. Not enough to protect you from enemy, you know, fucking grenades and shit, and, is that alive? Oh, God, that's one of those things, isn't it? Yeah,
let's set this up.
Yeah, they've got one of those little rocket launcher thing. Oh, maybe I shouldn't go outside whilst the bombs are falling. Oh, motherfucker. Really? You come... Ah. Well, I see the AI still can't defend a point worth a fucking damn. All of my AI was sitting there, and none of them took any shots at the enemy. Hmm. Probably because they still have terrible vision cones.
The enemy pushed us back.
This is again. I wonder if they shouldn't buff their. Nah, they probably shouldn't. They're already a little bit sneaky, but one of like the big things how AI spots you in this game is their vision code. And this is also why flanking is in this game, as in every single other shooter game in existence, quite literally. Flanking is king, because if you flank, you get around the AI's vision code. And seriously, I'm behind a wall. It's like, I'm greyline camping as far back as I humanly can, because I'm a tank. I know, it's fucking infuriating. God, I hate tanks. That's why flanking is king, because if you get in behind or on the side of the AI, 9 times out of 10, they'll simply just stand there retardedly and let you kill all of them. Also, they really need to do something with the tanks again. Because right now, since everybody's got bazookas, it's really dangerous to... Uh-huh, like I said. It's... Oh, fuck, are we doing the AT spam too? Ugh. It's really dangerous for the tanks to actually go anywhere. Back in the day, when people didn't have that much in the way of anti-tank gear, the tanks were actually relatively offensive. You know, they were used to push points. Whereas now, the grey line camping is worse than fucking ever, I swear to God. I mean, you can't barely even see half of these fuckers. Oh, well. I wanted that machine gun, but I couldn't have it. I think, like, personally, I would make it so that I would reduce the amount of the grey line dramatically. So the tanks actually have to pull off. I would probably even probably make it so that the grey line is completely banned for tanks entirely. Like, you just don't get to sit in it at all. You have to move up. Because that would make being a tank actually, you know, dangerous. Rather than what it is now, where being a tank is about sitting as far away from anything and everything possible, and just generally hazing down the rough position of the enemy with machine gun fire and HE. I see my aircraft still has a little bit of a transparency issue. Very well then. Because the only way to deal with a grey line camping tank is either A, having your own tank and having it be bigger than theirs, in which case you can shoot it and kill it from a very long range, or by having an aircraft with sufficient bomb load capacity. Eh, damn it, nothing. I was trying to fish a little bit there. Now, I did see an enemy aircraft do a strafe a little while ago. And I've got no idea where, so we're just going to head back and rearm for the time being. Or by again having a bomber. But even the bomber, you require constant communication with the ground, because you need actually people to point them out for you. And even then, you're going to need like a 500-pounder bomber or something to make sure you can actually kill them. Yeah, that's friendly. I mean, it shouldn't be over here if it isn't. Is that a... Yeah, it's a float plane. Cute. Brought him to 500 points halfway through. Not great by any stretch of the imagination, but not awful. Did he? Yeah, that was a strafing run, but I think the dude killed himself.
Need enemy vehicle position.
Right. Anybody know where anybody is? There. All right. Yeah, not bad, not bad. 6 kills. I'll take it. Hold on. I mean, this sure does give me a far better field of view, I can't lie. It's difficult to argue with that point. In fact, I would... Ooh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Most assuredly, yeah. Enemy bombers. Oh, God, that is... Those are point piñatas, the likes of which you rarely see. I do have to figure out where they are. Alright, where are the point piñatas? There the point piñatas are. It's difficult to argue that this does not give you at least a slight advantage over the enemy, as you can see them a hell of a lot better than they can see you. Right, any enemy fighters coming in? Okay, you're over there. But you're already on fire, and there's one guy over there too. Right. In that case, do not mind if I do. Just come in right over here and gut the fuck out of this formation. Wiggle a bit. I'm surprised they didn't shoot at me. Can they not see my aircraft either? Are they too just like, I wonder what the fuck's shooting? Wait. Are my bullets coming out of my camera? Hold on. No, they're not. Okay, I was wondering there for a second because I felt like I was aligning myself really, really well. But no, it's not that overpowered. Okay, well, that's nice.
Heresy's the question. Fire.
Ah, there you go. Yep, shoot down a whole bomber wing and you will get loads of fucking points. Goddamn. Right, well, I am enjoying this bug so far. Bird flu, see, William, Arch, were you ever military in your country? No, in fact, I'm not allowed to join the military for reasons I'm also not really allowed to talk about. But no, I was not. Oh, can you respot that real quick, somebody? I mean, I've got fucking tiny little rockets. I don't think I can actually kill that thing, but, you know, I'll give it a go. No. That was as direct a hit as direct hits get, and it just kind of bounced off its front plate, so. Sorry, boys. I am of absolutely no use to you when it comes to cracking armor, which is kind of a problem because that's the primary purpose of aircraft, really, but oh well. Right, we'll just hose down the general area, but no joy. This isn't going very well, I admit. Points, 2 points left. Not great. I miss the old HVAR rockets. The ones that could absolutely annihilate fucking Tiger tanks through the front plates. They were pretty snazzy. Pretty retardedly OP as well, mind you, but pretty snazzy nonetheless. Right. That was very speculative. Oh, hi. Hello. Hi there. I see you. How hard is my turn? My turn is good. Oh, Jesus. Ah, fuck me. Right, well, this is going to be a problem. Yep, I got one dude behind me, and I've got another fighter up there. This is probably not going to work out very well. Yep, no. I stopped my turn because I saw the other fighter, wondering if that was a... Oh, now it appears. Okay, so it is there so that I can see through it. I could have killed the BF-110 fairly easily, but... I had a brain fart moment there where I thought that he was in front of me all of a sudden. Like, yeah. Should have just continued the turn, I could have killed the 110. Assuming the BF-110 and 109 didn't bounce me, of course. Alright, 275 points. Hello. Fucking see Deutsch? Yep, I think they do. I'm getting hit markers on them, so I'm pretty sure they're not American. Always a surefire way to tell if somebody is German or not is to just fucking shoot them repeatedly. Do you have a health pack? I don't. If they say, ow, then they're American. If they say, ach, nein, well... The grease gun is not the finest medium to long-range weapon in the game. I bet you that fucking Tiger 2 there has been sitting... Interesting. Has been alive this entire game. Just killing people at maximum range with HE. Ah, yep, definitely. Yeah, so that's a premium vehicle. The rocket launcher there is a premium vehicle. Ah, somebody with actual air-to-ground weaponry killed them. Nice. I have 3 bullets left in my stupid little gun. Less than ideal.
Easier for us both if you just died already.
The enemy has started capturing the control point.
All right, 12 bullets. 12 bullets and a quarter health. Oh, yeah, that was predictable. Right, come on. Come on, ow. Ah. Yeah, no. I wanted to just rush on the point there, but I also saw the streamers of... you know, fire coming towards me and figured about it, I was just gonna die anyways. And then the, you know, bombs landed in front of me too. Die, bitch! Die, bitch! Where's that coming from? Nowhere. Burn, Nazis! Burn! Burn in the fires of Auschwitz. There you go. Oh, wow! A fucking half-track. Lovely. The enemy has Tiger 2s, and we've got a half-track. Delectable. Just the kind of matchmaking I expect out of Gaijin in general, though... come on. That... I'm pretty sure that hit, bitch. Come on. To be fair, this is mostly my fault for bringing a lot of... presumably lower levels up here as well. And myself only being tier 3, but... I, like most modern people, is of the opinion that personal responsibility is... not only overrated, but frankly, a thoroughly negative concept that is to be rejected at every turn. Right, that'll not hurt him at all, but... it'll annoy him and block his line of view, which is something. Was that a half-track? Well, yes, but was is unfortunately the correct terminology.
Don't let the enemy fortify their position.
Fortify their position? I'm sorry, but I'm pretty sure they're attacking the position. Alright. Die.
He wasn't so hard to kill.
I shot him in the face with a fucking bolt-action rifle and he died. Wow. Yes. It's remarkable how that works. Ow, come on. I fucking shot first. Slight server lag. Annoying. See, now their tanks are getting a lot more aggressive and that's because they're running out of stuff. Right. Just get on the point. Is that enemy paratroopers? It probably is, because people do like using paratroopers because they're gay. Hello, AI.
The enemy's trying to capture our control point.
Spotted me through a fucking bush. Yep, those are paratroopers. I do think they probably need to remove paratroopers, in my opinion. Or, at the very least, they need to not allow them to drop directly on the point. I don't know what the fuck they were thinking when they did that. It's like, how? This'll be fun? Now people can take the point before anyone even gets an opportunity to get back to defend the point. Well, why would you do that, though, Gaijin? That's really, really retarded. And you know that's not going to be balanced in the slightest unless, I don't know, you give them, like, no weaponry. And then Gaijin are also like, oh, I know. What if we also give them, like, Fallschirmjägergewehrs and 50-round drum mag Thompsons? Yeah, I got you. That certainly would make things a lot worse, I agree. Fuck you. Oh, you're not probably dead, are you? Let's put you out of your misery. There we go. 25 points left. I don't know. I'm beginning to feel this. Yeah, rushed. Alright, somebody definitely knows I'm up here by now. Let's go make sure we're actually on the point. We've got 13 points left. Yep, I am on the point. We've still got majority control of it. Actually, this is on the point. Oh, wow. I didn't expect it to be quite this generous, but it is. That felt good, but apparently not. I can't help but notice the repeated impacts of bullets against my little perch here. Almost as if the Germans don't like me being up here. Weird. Yeah. Not used to the Springfield yet. I've been spending too much time with the Japanese bolt actions as of late. This despite the fact that the Springfield is actually an exquisite bolt action. Fuck you. It really is. Very accurate, very comfortable sights, very good damage. It's an excellent bolt action rifle. Probably one of the best in the game, honestly. Whew. Right, we actually won that. Huh, not too bad. Not too shabby. And considering I was, two tiers under-leveled there, that's not too bad. 5,000 points, third place. I'll take it. Alright. Zingoy, I'm sorry. You're gonna have to go. You're too high a level. Let's see. Another Draconis. Draconis is here now. Let's see if Draconis wants to be invited. There we go. And we'll rotate people out after, a couple of games, I'm thinking. One to five. Who's still in five, Draconis? 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 Or is it just, I don't know. Is it the three? Ah, yeah, it's because three, isn't it? Three lets you go into rank one to five matches, which I've whined about before, and I shall whine about again. Look it up. You ready? There you go. It's a very dumb thing, in my opinion, to be like, okay, we've got a... There we go. We've got a mid-tier here. Thank you! I take your award, teasing me. You've got a mid-tier, which is three, which is when you've gotten out of the earliest tier, and you've gone past second tier, which is like the baby plus tier, and now you're in tier three. And suddenly, you can play in everything from tier one to tier five. From the very bottom tier to the absolute highest tier. I'm sorry, but that sounds very, very retarded, and I don't think you should be allowed to do that. Jonathan Smith asks, World of Warship Day sometime. Not impossible. I haven't played World of Warships in absolute ages, because I really dislike the introduction of the submarines. I'm not fond of those at all. Like, I was already getting a bit annoyed by their torpedo meta in many ways, and now they've added torpedoes that you can't see. Wow, that sounds terrible. Oh, well, yes, baby. Okay, this is probably an excellent opportunity to break out a tank then. Oh, the Japanese. Okay. Either this is like Japanese tier 4, in which case we're probably going to get our asses fucking pounded into the dirt. Or this is Japanese tier 3 or 2 or... Oh, God help me, 1. In which case this will be a very one-sided slaughter, but in the opposite direction. Let's find out. Right, well, On this map, what you simply do is you point your tank towards the hills, and then you just go right up the hills. The Japanese... Oh, hello. The Japanese have a very, very hard time dealing with Allied armor. A very hard time. Like, as somebody who's played actually primarily Japanese, oh Jesus, it's... Like, painful does not begin to describe the experience of playing Japan, okay? When you get up tier this Japan... Japan tier 1, 2, and 3 is the worst kind of purgatory you have ever experienced. It is just awful. Like, everything you have is just objectively worse than the Allied equivalent. Your tanks are worse, your aircraft are worse, your SMGs are worse. Whereas, like, the only area in which you have, not superiority by any stretch of the imagination, but at least parity, is bolt-action rifles. And even that's a little iffy. It is a nightmare. It is a nightmare and a half. Oh. Something just bounced harmlessly off my superior American armor. There's a Japanese tanker ranker over there. I can penetrate him literally anywhere. He can penetrate me basically nowhere. As demonstrated by this engagement. He shoots me first. He does nothing. Oh god, Akami. Oh no, it's low tier Japan. Oh, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. I have suffered enough on the receiving end of this to not wish to do this to somebody else. Oh no. Oh god. That's terrible. Oh, that's awful. That is absolutely awful. My deepest sympathies, Japanese team. My deepest sympathies. This will be hard for you. I'm not gonna lie, it's gonna suck. It's gonna suck quite a bit. You're probably not gonna have a lot of fun. Oh, hello, is that another tank? Alright, I would love to kill that too, just because, you know, if we're being cunts about this, I feel as we, well, as we might just be full-on cunts, I guess. I think that's probably a little bit too steep for me to go up. The fucking Kami has like a 47mm cannon. It stands absolutely no chance in everlasting fucking hell of doing anything to the Sherman at all. Like, it can practically get behind the Sherman and shoot it and it'll bounce. Oh, God help me. Right, let's go find ourselves a Japanese tank. We haven't captured the first point yet, which mildly shocks and surprises me, honestly. Normally, this should be a pretty quick run over. Right, where is that damn thing? Oh, you're great. Okay, you know, I don't feel as bad about killing you now, because that's some pretty deep raylining you're doing there, buddy bro. That's some pretty deep raylining you're doing there. And we don't like grayliners in these parts. Good evening, sir. Prepare yourself to be fucked very one-sidedly and very brutally. You stand no chance, no hope. Just abandon your vehicle and allow yourself to die. Explode already, come on. There we go. Right, now to tip my brutally overpowered weapon, more or less in the direction of the enemy's infantry, and resume the slaughter, I guess. Anybody down there? Oh, hello. Another fun and engaging point of balance. Huh? Did something actually penetrate me there? So I felt as if something gently tickled my front armor for a moment. Eh. Probably my imagination. I felt as if something lightly brushed against me. It must have been a Japanese anti-tank weapon. I'm mildly disappointed we haven't taken this yet. There we go. Oh, hello. A group of Japanese people. Die! Die horribly. I hear tank tracks. Oh, no. That's just humans. Oh, I've got a tank next to me. That's why I can hear tank tracks. Okay, fair enough. Nice. The 75mm Sherman shell passed through the fucking tree and still splashed four little Japs on the other side. How brutally unfair. I don't even know what'd be on the ground here. I wanna give the Japanese the largest chance they can of actually doing something by keeping myself out of the fight. Because I will say this, okay? As much as the Japanese experience is one of pain, suffering, screaming, tears, and general incredibly one-sided and volatile ass rape, it does have its advantages, okay? It breeds resilience in you, for example. If you manage to grind your way from Japanese Tier 1 to Japanese Tier 4, then you will be a man of steel, okay? You will be resilient in a way that no other faction can ever possibly truly understand. You will have stared into the deepest depths of darkness that this video game can provide for you, and you will have cried. Oh. I heard something else bounce off my front armor. More Japanese anti-tank weapons. God, I'm... Okay, let's get moving forwards here to some degree. Can I get up here? Let's see. Wow, normally I'd be really scared about showing my flank armor and stuff to the enemy, but hey, the enemy's Japan, so who cares? They can't penetrate my flank either. Was that a tank? No. Was that a tank? I feel like that was a tank. Oh. There be Japs in over in them there bushes. Oh boy. Okay, something large enough to actually penetrate me. Wow. That's unusual. What is it? Alright. Oh, is that an anti- Yeah, it's an anti-tank gun, I'm presuming. Yep, judging by its rate of fire. I mean, it's still bouncing like mad, but... Right. There you go, keep shooting. I'm just gonna pop out and... One of our parts needs for a needed... Out of parts needed for repair? What? Aww. Right, hold on. I'm gonna go back inside and select another person. Right, do you have any repair parts? You don't! Oh, there you go. Ah, gosh darn it. Right, well, he can't actually hurt me anymore. Because I've actually now pointed myself towards him, so he literally cannot penetrate my tank. As you can see. But, quite tragically, I can't actually repair my tank either. Aw. Alright, fine. I guess I'll have to abandon my little, poor little tank. I have not equipped my tank crew at all, have I? I've got a knife.
The control point is ours. Move out to the next one.
Oh, well. What, 38 kills? I'll take it. God, the Japanese. Like, I'm not even gonna feel bad if we lose this. I'm actually kind of hoping we do. Banzai! Oh, I died.
Enemy bombers are approaching.
Enemy bombers? Oh, yes! Okay! I've got a cockpit this time. How unusual. Enemy bombers? Enemy bombers? Okay, I think they're coming from over there. Enemy bombers. Yes. Yes, so many points. Was there an enemy aircraft down there? I feel like I saw one. Yes, there is. Hi. Hello there. Oh. I keep forgetting how incredibly maneuverable the P-38 is. He's going towards my bombers. Now there's their bombers. Okay. I've probably got time to shoot this guy down first, unless, of course, my friendly bombers tear him into fucking shreds first. Yeah, I figured. Too greedy of me. I wanted him and the enemy bombers. Should have just gone for the bombers. Right, begin turning into them. And since we've got some rockets, might as well test my luck. Nice. One fucking pass. Tore four of them out of the sky. Brilliant. And let's make it a clean sweep. There we go. 4,595 points. Very nice, very nice. We are actually kind of losing. 669 points left, and we're in the third point. Japanese are doing well. I am going to continue to not take an active part in this because I'll be honest with you, I have more sympathy for the Japanese than I have for the Allies in this particular match. I really unironically do. That doesn't mean I won't torment them from the sky, of course. And whore every single point I can out of the situation. And I hope they bring more bombers. I do love shooting down bombers. Come on, Japs. Gird your loins.
Need enemy vehicle coordinates.
Grab your testicles, Japanese people. You can do this. Fight. Fight for your little yellow lives. No one else will. Right, thank you kindly to whoever put down those little marker Doritos. Those were very well aimed indeed. Thank you. Jonathan Smith says, in a cockpit. How unusual. Streams with Gibbs. That's true. He is quite the little cockpit. There's no denying it. Oh, God, I keep forgetting how fucking maneuverable this thing is. This thing is a fighter, by the way. This is the Allied equivalent of a fighter, basically. And it feels like it. It's fast, it's maneuverable. But despite, you know, most other nations' fighters, they either need to sacrifice firepower or durability or maneuverability or something. Not so for the P-38 Lightning. It's got speed, it's got guns, it's got basically everything you could ever possibly desire out of an aircraft, and as a final little finish, it also carries air-to-ground missiles. Because the Allies are just unfathomably spoiled when it comes to air power. That's why. Right, some more Doritos. Last time I fired at the Doritos, I was handily rewarded, so I shall do so again. One kill, and I damaged a truck. I'll take it. And the worst part is, this is a tier 2 fucking aircraft. Oh god, I have complained about the P-38 at length previously, and I will do so again, because the P-38 is, again, tier 2, and yet it outperforms every Japanese aircraft save the tier 4 top of the line fighter, okay? I've got the tier 4 top of the line Japanese fighter, and it's good. It is pretty damn good, don't get me wrong. It's got good forward firing weapons, good speed, good maneuverability, decent bomb load. It's an excellent fighter, but it's tier 4. And I would still feel entirely comfortable taking it on in the P-38, which should not be the case. I saw streamers there, and that, I believe, is my next victim. Come here, you little nit bitch, you. Don't try to run, you'll only die tired. It's like, I'm gonna go back and get some more ammunition. I hope somebody doesn't randomly come up behind me and violently fuck my virginity right out of my asshole. That would be terrible. Yep, yeah, it would. It certainly would suck. But hey, if you don't want that to happen to you, don't play the Japanese. Little truck right there. We'll just pour a buttload of 20 mil into it. Toss out a few rockets. It sure would suck if a big, burly American in a vastly superior aircraft would just slot in behind me and slaughter me. It would. It would. And hey, don't get me wrong, it's historically accurate. It really, really is. Japan had no business going to war with America. It really didn't. Like, even their most famous aircraft, the Zero, like, everybody's, oh, Japanese Zero. Ah, Zero. Zero, very famous. The Zero was outdated by 1936, okay? It was already out of date by the time they attacked Pearl Harbor, by, like, several years. And yet, it's basically the only thing the Japanese had that was at least mildly, kind of, in a way, comparable to the American stuff. And even then, I say comparable in the loosest possible fucking terms. Anything more for me to shoot out of the sky? No? Okay, I'll go get some more rockets then. Like, the only thing the Japanese had with actual quality was stuff like the Betty, for example. Was it the B? The B4N2? The medium bombers. They were pretty good. They had excellent range, carried a fairly respectable bomb load. They were, of course, not armored in the slightest and had virtually no defensive armament whatsoever. But, it was a trade-off the Japanese made. As the Japanese made to maximize range at the expense of everything else. And they had some unbelievably long-legged aircraft. They surprised the Americans again and again, because the Americans kept thinking they would be way out of range of any sort of Japanese aircraft. You know, the silly little nippy whippies couldn't possibly build anything that could reach them all the way to Pearl Harbor. Well, on that note, triple kill. I hear aircraft engines. And yep, there he is. Okay. Well, I can't just bounce your ass straight off the carrier, as much as I would love to, as that truly would be the absolute biggest dick move in history. But the AA will shoot me down. Right. Where did he go? Is he going to do an attack run? Did he see me? Is he going to try to go for me? No, there he is. Right, I believe you have left the safety of your carrier's little protective AA bubble right now, sir. And so I'm just gonna do this.
Come on, boys. There's just one control.
You're not dead? That's unusual.
Oh, careful there.
Pulling a little bit too many G's. Are you sure you're not dead? Normally, you should be dead by now. Oh. Allow me to correct my mistake. There we go.
Already,
Ah, so fucking cruel. Oh, hello! Hi there! Oh, that's a zero. Okay. Right. My only chance... He is does have superior maneuverability. He got very lucky there. Killed me in one hit. With the 7-7 machine guns, too. Wow, that was lucky. Fucking hell. Because he was very close. If I'd managed to pass through his guns there once, I'd probably have gotten him by scissoring. Oh well, I did deserve to die. It had taken far too long. God help me, it had been too long. Oh, 59 kills, 7,000 points. Ah, yes, the Spitfire. No, you actually can use Spitfires in this tier too. And the Spitfire, like, the one thing the Zero has over the P-38 is its... Ooh, hi there. I saw you, bitch. The one thing the Zero has is its turn rate, right? It turns better. Now, you can still out-scissor it fairly easily as well, actually, but you do have a turning advantage in a Zero over a 38, as you obviously should. Guten Tag und Yups. Konnichiwa. I've got a Thompson. Get snuffed. Superior American weapons technology. Get fucking stuffed. Banzai. Oh, hello. That's a... Yep. That's a bit too many of them. Only 300 points left. God. We might still lose this. We might still lose this. It's possible. It could happen. Granted, I don't think I've ever seen anybody actually hold this point successfully. I don't think I've seen it happen ever. This point is awful. Largely because the Americans, the Allies, they actually get a spawn point. Oh, hello. On this point's flank. Right. Hello there, little Japanese open-topped vehicle. I have a flamethrower. You've seen me. Ah. I hoped I could get past it there. I could not. So yeah, the Spitfire. The Spitfire will actually outturn the Zero, which nullifies its one and... Ooh, hello. Just point that out there so my tank, or our tank, can kill it. Which nullifies the Zero's one and only advantage. Ah, fucking... Okay, alright. We've got campers up there, do we? We do. Alright, that's smart for them. That is kind of how the Japanese have to play, by camping like fucking mad, but... The issue is, you do need people on the point as well. Let's see if they have people on the point as well. Let's see, can I sneak a... Nope. Right. I'm not going to be able to advance from that point. Not without killing it first, which I could, but no. Let's give them a chance. Could just jump in a Sherman and revenge kill it, but that'd be too easy. No, we're gonna try and take this the good old-fashioned traditional way. Let me give them a shot. That's mostly friendly tracer. Like, the American team is actually not doing very well here, if I'm to be honest. Like, normally, this should be much more of a walkover. There's the Japanese tank, just shelling. I don't think this is gonna work. Ah, yeah. I figured. Hi.
Whoop.
Stab, 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 stab. Alright, 7 kills. Come on, somebody, kill that tank up there. Jesus, what are you doing? You can easily kill it. Instead of just sitting on the hill, you know what it is. Just murder it. I'm not gonna do it. It'd be cruel if I did it. Alright, there's a little nip in the window there. This is dangerous. That was almost a good throw.
Yes.
Nice, toasty, toasty. Nice. You're American. Don't burn the Americans. You're also American. I'm sorry. I burned the American. Don't worry about it. It's okay. You probably deserved that. Come on, dudes! Oh, we are actually gonna lose this. I'm impressed. I'm very impressed by the Japanese. Good job. I'm very disappointed by my team, though. This is not hard. I've gotten up here easily every time. You can easily take this point. Ah, damn it. This is not a difficult point to take. Good job, Japanese. You deserve that. Very disappointed in my fellow Americans. Very disappointed. They didn't build any spawn points. They didn't even manage to get up there properly. They never killed the tank. See, this is why you should play as the Japanese, okay? Because it'll teach you valuable lessons in preservation, of going at it no matter the odds, you know? Of becoming a better player. Very important. I highly recommend you play the Japanese, even if it's gonna hurt a little bit here and there. Even if it's gonna suck just a tiny bit. points. Oh, God. That was such... See, normally, under most circumstances, I would probably push to win those just because it doubles your points, but... No. Nah, yeah. I don't... It doesn't feel right, does it? It doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel right. Let's see. What have you got for you? A suppressed grease gun. That is about the dumbest thing I think I've ever actually heard. I guess you can have a Lancaster. And another toolkit, because we do need more tools. And you never know who dies in these things.
Question. Fire is the answer.
Nice. Let's see, we'll change out, looking up, let's see if there's anybody else around. Shunush, let's try and find him. Pineapple Juice, I think I invited him, but he wasn't there. Let's see if he's there now. And, okay, yeah. I can also see if chat is being a little pissy about it as well. Like, you shouldn't throw matches. I agree. You shouldn't throw matches. But I didn't throw it. I was playing. Yeah, I was doing my thing. I just wasn't trying as hard as I could, you know? Because I do sympathize with the poor Japanese. I really, really unironically sympathize with the Japanese. Oh, God. Like, you saw the Sherman, right? It was just sitting there, taking shot after shot to its front armor from an anti-tank gun. Just bing, 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 bing. It's just dumb. It's just stupid. And you saw what I did with this one Thompson, literally, going into the house, killing like 12 people by my fucking self. The Japanese deserve a little bit of... a little bit of nicety. I think so. Pineapple Jupes is still not there. Let's see if anybody else is there. Nordace. There we go. The Japanese deserve to be approached with honor. Honorable. In honorable combat. I think so. Johnson Smith, means justify the ends or ends justify the means? Both, depending on. Machine gun fortifications. Fortifications. I do hate jet fortifications. See, there are definitely occasions in which the ends justify the means. Absolutely. Like, you've got the strategic bombing of Germany during the Second World War. That was pretty horrible, right? And it lasted for a very long time. And they kept doing it even after they basically realized that bombing industry was kind of pointless and just kind of started bombing cities. Hell, the British started with that shit. But defeating Nazi Germany was kind of important, so there you go. But that is also definitely cases in which the means justify the ends, you know? Non-violent resistance is in and of itself a virtuous a goal, and it lends credibility to the ends that you are trying to achieve. Not in all cases. It depends on the means and on the ends, as most things. Chinese. That's true. The Chinese were not treated particularly honorably by the Japanese. Okay. Let's put it like this. If there was a Chinese nationalist front in this game, and I wish there was, by the way, then I'd be pretty happy not treating the Japanese honorably, okay?
Heresy's the question.
Then I'd be fine with it.
Fire is the answer.
The Japanese and the Chinese deserve to war crime each other as much as they possibly can. And I... oh, not again. Okay. I do need to level up my Sherman, so fine. Crazy Templar, donated $3. Thank you very much via Streamlabs. Do you have any book recommendations for learning about the Pacific Far East theaters of World War II? Absolutely. Let me just actually go and check out so I recognize the author name. I've got it in my bookshelf here. Let's see. Ian W. Toll is the name of the author. Oh, did somebody take my tanky wanky? Aw. Ian W. Toll. He has written a trilogy about the Pacific War that I highly recommend. It is an incredibly good series. They're nice, they're thick, they're massive books. Oh. I thought that was a little Japanese person there for a second. And they go into a lot of detail, and they're very, very, very readable. Very readable. They're not at all dry historic texts. They manage the art of combining good, raw, proper information with an informative and entertaining read. Highly recommend E.W. Toll's The War in the Pacific series. Excellent stuff. Nips in the trenches already. Disgusting. How many nips can there be in a tiny little house? Lots, apparently. Oh, that's a brilliant time to reload. Brilliant time to hide. Interesting. Brilliant time to reload indeed. The Rising. Ah, the Rising. It is a brutally underestimated weapon. Don't let him advance. It is the Tier 1 American SMG. Vacon is calling out strategic bombers, no doubt. This is not a good place to be. I'm probably getting shot by a tank. You're looking at me. You're not. Let's mark you so somebody can maybe kill you. The Rising is terribly underestimated. People don't use it enough. It's really good, actually. I think a lot of people don't use it because it's got kind of low rate of fire, kind of low damage and stuff, which is all true. But, oh, there's going to be a lot of people up there, aren't there? Yeah, there probably is. But, oh god, I'm dead. Lay down. No, I'm not. Yay. But it's got really good damage. Well, not damage, but it's got really good accuracy, actually, was what I was looking for. And it sounds beautifully. He's still alive. Somebody kill him. Somebody with an aircraft. Murder him now. I demand. I mean, listen to that thing. It sounds like a fucking bolt gun. I love it. If nobody's gonna kill him, then I'm gonna kill him. I don't like little Japanese tanks. And hey, I gave them one game of merciful honor. I feel like I deserve being a little bit more tryhardy in this one to get my points out of it. That enemy aircraft is probably dead. Is he turning towards the carriers? Yes, he probably is. Is that an enemy? No, it is not. Okay. For a moment there, I forgot what my rocket key was. Yes, you're allied. Yeah, I was wondering there for a second because I couldn't see the pip on it. I gave the Japanese one good honorable fight. I'll give them only a half an honorable fight in this one. Only half. I'll start intervening more directly if we start losing badly. Nationalist China would be a lot of fun. I would enjoy Nationalist China. Lots of stupidly basic bitch low-tier weaponry. Lots of bolt-action rifles. A focus on, like, armored cars and stuff. That'd be fun. I'd like that. Like, the heaviest anti-tank weapon would be an anti-tank rifle, and it would actually be effective. I saw traces. Oh, there you are. Interesting aerial acrobatics there, sir. Are you... you an enemy? You're turning away to the Japanese ammo point, so I'm presuming you're a bad guy. And... die, die, die. I've not been having good luck with my 20 mils today. I'm kind of sad by that. Been having the most awful luck with them. And he's going back to the carrier, which is smart. We'll see if he makes it. Normally the 20 mils absolutely obliterate the little bastards, but... oh, hi. Okay. Somebody built an AA turret, and I was marked. Ah. It is still very easy to counter aircraft. You just need to actually build the AA turrets, and very few people actually do build the AA turrets. Actually, I do have a mission to kill people with machine guns. Come on. Yeah. Nobody builds them anymore. Or they build them very rarely. Which is a shame. Because it makes people think that the aircraft are more powerful than they are, when they really are not. Yeah, Japanese are just... not attacking at all right now, are they? Ah, snipers. This is going to be a bit of a frustrating fight, isn't it? Because the Japanese are just sitting there. They've already kind of given up on attacking. That bolt action shot to the head didn't actually kill them, which I find mildly aggravating. And so the Americans just kind of sit there too. Not gonna get any kills like this. That's a Japanese person. It's another Japanese person. Are they over here? They are! Yay! Come back! I need your blood. Aww. That was it.
Hold them back.
Come on, little nippies. Attack! Be not such cowardly creatures. I'm also supposed to be building like spawn points and stuff to get my missions done, but eh. Rock often has Japanese people by it. Nothing. AI. There we go. You just sit over there. I can hear Japanese people. There do be nips nearby. There do be nips nearby. It's just a question of actually finding them. They're not getting killed by the constant artillery and sniping. Nip.
One left.
Nip. Nip.
You want some
nip. Nip. There we go. Nips. More nips? Nip. No? Ah. He was just twitching as he died.
Don't let them advance.
A fairly classical Pacific match this. The Japs attack like once, maybe twice, realizing that no balance patch has actually arrived for the game since last time they attacked. And then they kind of stop attacking. Nip. 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 No? I feel like there's tracers coming from up there somewhere. I'm feeling pretty sure there's tracers coming from up there somewhere. Japanese tanks are chilling in their base. They should at least climb the hill, you know, make it a bit more easy for them to do something. Aw. I was shot in the face by a cannon. Alright, let me just climb up here. I'm sure nobody is gonna see and shoot me up on this massive and incredibly obvious rock. Yeah. See, the annoying part is you're also dealing with the enemy snipers who are actually snipers. I do hate snipers. I don't like snipers. I hate snipers. It's such a passive role, and you basically only break them out when this is happening, so that you can sit in your fucking spawn and snipe. It's like, it's boring. People should be forced to attack more violently. There should come a commissar into your spawning circle and be like, if you haven't left in 30 seconds, I'm just gonna fucking shoot you in the head. I'd like that. No nips on that little high explosive fishing trip either. Nips. Nips in the hills. Hill nips. An often underappreciated sub-variant of the common nip. They've got pretty good climbing abilities. You know, they can go pretty much up a straight hill without any real problems. But much like their fellow nips, they tend to attract bullets. The nip is a fairly low-level animal. Creature, sorry YouTube. Their survival instinct is highly limited. It never truly evolved on their tiny island habitat. And so they keep running directly towards the enemy, repeatedly, again and again, despite seeing how that works out. Sometimes they attempt, like the climbing nip, to... Hello. Nip snipers. The worst kind of nip. Die. The climbing nip is a slight variant on the standard nip. It attempts to carry out a tactic that it's heard from other people called flanking. Unfortunately, this map really doesn't allow for all that much in the way of flanking, and there is no cover in the direction that the climbing nip attempts to flank in, often forcing it to turn into the more standard variant, which is the ground nip, which is the one you can see right here, currently charging wildly towards my Springfield as I try to take aim as the ground shakes around. The survival rate of the ground nip is even worse than the climbing nip, and so if you have to choose between one or the other, I highly suggest you always choose to be the climbing nip. Never choose to be the sniping nip, though. Nobody likes them. Thank you for peeking out around the corner there. 42 kills, I guess I'll take it. There's also the armored nip. Now, the armored nip is even more defensive than the ground nip, but it does survive for longer periods of time. This has allowed it to develop a far more effective mating call strategy than its average competitors. Despite this, their numbers are quite small. Presumably because, despite that increased survival rate, the fact that they spend all their days hiding in an armored box makes their penises very small. If nothing else, hiccups. Playing on Guadalcanal does make it a lot easier to level stuff up. Squad size. That one's already fully leveled up. I do have tankers. Let's see. Sherman 2. The Sherman 2 is kind of pointless, honestly. Is the Sherman 1? Sherman 2 is the one I have, is it? Yes, okay. Right, we'll upgrade the Sherman 2 then. I'm not going to bother with the other one. Machine Gunners. You are kind of terrible and I don't like you very much. T-Gunner. Nice. We should institute something like the Hug a Chinese month that we did in the early days of COVID. Hug a Japanese player. Yes, that's what we need. Hug a Japanese player. And to show a little bit of sympathy and a little bit of regard for what they're doing, you know. A little bit of appreciation. Give them a good pet on the back. Make sure that they feel that their efforts are not completely pointless. Ah. Tunisia. No nips on Tunisia. Italians instead. Filthy, dirty, spaghetti-eating scoundrels. Oh, actually, oh great. Arch, you have Draconis on your team. That is no wonder you lost then. Draconis does enjoy the strategic bombing run a little bit too much. See, the strategic bombing run is cute, but that's also kind of all the strategic bombing run is, in my opinion. It's cute, but it's shit. Because it actually makes it so that you, I can put the spawn point right here. Oh, nice. Okay, well, I will. The bombing run makes it so that you can't actually do your artillery strike instead, because it actually blocks access to the artillery strike. And fair enough, if you were able to do artillery strikes and bombing runs simultaneously, that would be kind of retarded. I'm not going to deny it. But the thing with the bombing run is that it takes ages for it to actually get there. And so, since it takes so long to get there, you're actually holding up your team's access to artillery for a very long time. Which in turn means that your team aren't going to bomb anybody, whereas the enemy team is going to bomb you. And if the one team is constantly pouring artillery down on the other, and the other team isn't really returning that artillery fire in kind, that can get really, really, really uncomfortable really, really quickly. There you go.
Got it. Give me cover.
You may have cover, sir. I'll put one there. I need to complete the mission that gives me, that is like, to make allies use 20 of your cover pieces, so that's what we're doing now. Placing down lots of cover for my allies to use and abuse. For them to pleasure themselves with. A little bit of barbed wire on the entrance. Never hurt anybody. Definitely not. Can I build that? I can. Huh. I have remarkably stretchy arms. And whilst we're at it, might as well plunk down a little bit of an ammo crate there, too. Love. We're playing support today. Now, if you want to make things extra difficult, you can actually put down tank traps there, too. Oh, people love that. People really love that. People really love that. Let's go there. You stinking little filthy fucking German! Is that paratroopers? I do hate paratroopers. You see that? Nope, no healing for you. Can I look through that? Oh, I can't. That would be fucking hilarious if I could. Just standing on tiptoes, shooting out of the bathroom fucking window. Oh. Oh, okay. Right, there's a sniper looking over here. How do you guys keep coming up here? Yeah, I don't want to stand in these windows anymore. Now, you see one puff of bullet pass by your nose, and you kind of grow a little bit hesitant, don't you? Well, I got him in the end. Hi.
Jesus Christ, this time.
I enjoyed the part where he slowly looked up at me because he probably just switched over to that character and he was like, well, I know he's up there, and then stared down the barrel of my bolt action. Ooh. Little bitches. Still trying to shoot me, eh? How dare you? Try. Yes, you're still trying. Luckily, he's not very good at aiming. If I stand still for long enough, I'm sure he will figure it out eventually. Ah, too early. Bitch. Really? Where the fuck did you come from then? Oh, oh, interesting. Why am I here? Okay. Bitch.
Ah!
That was American. We've got ourselves some hardcore flanky fucks here, don't we? Walking all the way around there just to try and revenge kill my ass. Very tasteless. Very unappreciated. I know there's a dude there. I'm trying to... Sometimes, Lee Enfield, you're a little bit confusing, you know that? Just sometimes, though. The Lee Enfield is one of, if... What? Excuse me? Okay, that was confusing. I was pretty sure I had him there. The Lee Enfield is one of, if not in fact, the single bet. Wow, he guessed well. He guessed exactly which window I was going to go to, huh? Hmm, I don't know about that. It's very accurate. It's got very comfortable sights. Though I'm a little bit confused as to which part of the little thingy-bob I was supposed to aim for. Which, I have no idea how the fuck that one missed. Right, I have no idea how two of three of those missed. Mildly infuriating. Also, the Germans aren't really attacking properly. Hello there, giant tanks. Yeah, I shouldn't be going down here, should I? I don't have any anti-tank weapons either, so I don't know why I came down here. This all seems... retarded. Thank you for the... pity kill, I guess. Never mind, they're all dead. Any delicious little spawn points down here for me to destroy? Any careless Italians not watching their backs? Normally, I would have expected there to be spawn points down here. Time to pay a little house visit, then. Ooh. Lucky little bastard. Yeah. That was a lovely case of ally gets in the way of every bullet ever. Okay, he did actually die, right? Let's have a little sweep with the trench broom then. Oh, hi. Missed every bullet, good job. Anybody up here? Give me that. I'm gonna be in need of extra ammo pretty soon if this keeps going on. Eager little beavers, aren't they? Did I see somebody over there? No. Hello? Are you looking for me, perchance? Oh, did you bring a... You did! Thank you! I was running out of ammunition there. Much appreciated. My little Germans. Bringing ammo for me to kill them with. Very kind, very generous. Very loving and adorable. Understanding, even. Right, we are currently sitting on their forward building, so this is... this is quite the fuckening for the Italian team, I'm afraid. Quite the brutish fuckening. Italians! That was slightly pathetic. Damn it. Ooh. What? Okay, he just shot me through a fucking solid brick wall, but I'm presuming that was because... Yeah, it was probably because he... Yeah, no, he probably wasn't on his screen. I saw him there, so I was taking my time because it looked like his gun was pointing in a completely different direction and blocked by the fucking brick. It wasn't blocked by the fucking brick, apparently. God, okay, we've fortified this point. Don't need to worry about that, I guess. Oh, artillery, do need to worry about that. God, this is not healthy to be running out in the open like this. Oh, hot. Okay. Any other weapon than the fucking bar, and that would have been a lot of kills. But it was the bar. So we have a little campy Italian behind us here. Somebody already dealt with him, it seems. They actually got to the point? How? There's so much barbed wire on it, I didn't think that was physically possible.
Need cover.
Nor did the rest of my team, I presume. That's why nobody's there. Very, very sneaky of the Germans. They lulled us into a false sense of security by killing themselves on the point. Not achieving anything. So they could come with a sudden rush from behind. Ah. But I want to go up there and camp. Damn. I wonder, can my retarded little anti-tank gun penetrate that? Let's find out. For what's about to happen to you, poor little British people inside of my brand carrier, I apologize, but know this. You were born British. Which means that no war crime I commit against you is actually technically a war crime at all. No matter what, you are as guilty of what I'm about to do as I am. There it is. Oh no, it's looking at me. That's unfortunate. Nope. No, my tiny little dumbass... My tiny dumbass gun cannot actually penetrate the tank. Well, it was worth a try. And now I know. And knowing is half the battle. Yes. Little shoyman, little shoyman, little shoy, 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 shoyman. I hear the report of something tanky. Oh, is that an ally? It's an ally. Okay, well, never mind. Perched on a rock. I oversee the land in front of me for German panzers. Is there anything? No, not really. But there isn't a pack over there. Not manned, however. For some reason, I have this incredible urge to start singing the Lion King song. I think it has something to do with my elevated position. Italians. The scum of the earth. Make them disappear. Nobody likes Italians. Nobody. That looked like a impact from a weapon, but it wasn't.
The enemy is sending explosives.
Oh no. They're on the point. Whatever shall we do? Actually, you know what? Let them. They've got 31. Oh, hi there. Jesus. Okay. That was a lot of stuff that spawned in there. And I've got HE loaded. Very, very unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. Not as unfortunate as it was for you. Ah. Fire. That was sudden. See, normally, it produces some smoke first to warn you, like, hey, your car's on fire. Not today. Today, we just became on fire. Wait, what happened to my spawn point? Oh, there it is. Oh, some little bitch put their spawn point right next to my spawn point. Very gay of them. Right, that was way too easy, and thus also not very profitable. I don't like it when the matches are one-sided like this, because it means you don't really get anything done, and the only people who earn points are the ones that even are either in airplanes, or are sitting somewhere in a tank, just continuously blasting people to pieces. Enemy failed to destroy any of the targets. At least I got that one out of the way. Special weapons. Oh god, I'm getting sick of this one. 40 enemies using a machine gun. I'm sorry, I don't have a machine gun. All I have is a dumbass fucking bar. I really don't like the bar. The bar is dumb. The bar is gay. The bar requires way too much XP to level up. The bar is dumb, the bar is gay. The bar is dumb and gay. Alright, let's see. Oh. Two of our little friends left. Okay, let's see if we can invite two other people in. Terrible. Meh. I think we played pretty much everyone who's been online so far. Alright, you know what? In that case, maybe a little bit of the Soviets. The poor little Soviets. The dumb little Soviets. Right, I can't have that weapon, because all of the BPS edges are battle rating 4 plus now. Something low tier, yes. Oh, do I not have... Oh, do I have the best I can get? Okay, fine. What's that, battle rating 2, 3? 1 to 4, really? Why, because the sniper SVT? Probably. Oh, God. What a terrible little aircraft. Let's see. Fighter. I've got that one. That's tier one. Really? The Illusion is a tier two aircraft. That doesn't seem right, but... Okay, if you say so. I don't actually have any of the flamethrower squads. But a mortar. Ah, oh, there we go. Okay, slot in that. Mozin. Winchester. Whoa. Winchester. Yes. We like Winchester. Ah, Soviet low tier. Oh boy. That's gonna be mildly terrible. Don't have any premium squads for you shits. I don't think so. I don't. Not very tragic. Boltman, aren't you? You missed me. Did I? Hold on. But you're not here. There's no Bob here. There's no Bob in my friend request either. Bad Bob. Soviet, 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 Soviets. Riffy, okay, Riffy. Riffy, Riffy, Riffy. Riffy, there you go. The Soviets used to be brutally overpowered. And still are, in, like, their actual, like, tiers. In tier 5, they are still an absolute fucking joke. Oh, absolute, 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 absolute joke. Absolute joke. The PPSH is just too goddamn good. It dominates everything. And they used to be able to get that as one of the earliest weapons in their campaigns. It was dumb. Like, the tier 5 is dominated by PPSHs because of their ridiculous ammunition capacity, their absurd rate of fire, and they're still competitively high damage. And those things used to go up against, on the regular, squads with, like, bolt-action rifles as their highest weapon. It was a terrible. The T-52 was just virtually invulnerable because the only thing the Germans had as a tank in the early Soviet campaign was like a fucking Panzer II. Like, literally, it could not penetrate the T-50 and so it just kept killing them. Oh, God, it's so dumb. Now, though, the PPSH has been placed where it belongs in tier, I think, 5 almost exclusively. I think there might be one in tier 4. If anybody's playing tier 2, then is. See, this is one of the issues with all games when they've been going for a while. With everyone having moved out of tier 1 and 2, nobody plays them. Because, well, why would you? Actually, though, to be fair, in this game, there's a much better... Ooh, I see. It's one of those little weird captured things, is it? Oh, Stalina. Popnichnik. Paprika. Right, I do need kills with special weapons, and this is a special weapon, so let's begin by just plonking down some random mortar rounds over on that objective over there. So far, not a lot of luck on my fishing trip. Precisely no luck whatsoever on my fishing trip. Very disappointing. Very, very disappointing. Hurrah! Ah, the famous Soviet battle cry. Hurrah! So actually, it's not what it sounds like ooh-rah. It's actually hoo-rah with the H. The old English battle cry. Hurrah! But the Soviets are dumb. And so they are not actually capable of pronouncing H's. This is something they have in common with certain Americans, by the way, for example, who pronounce herbalist as herbalist. It's some sort of brain damage, I think. I don't approve of it, and I condemn it whenever I see it, of course. Ow! Hey there! God, I love the Winchester. 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 Oh, the Winchester. Oh, I love the Winchester. No, don't get me wrong. The Winchester is... Noob tube! Oh, you little dirty cock-swallowing whore. Wow, okay. That was interesting. He hadn't actually reloaded his weapon and he still managed to kill me. Hmm. As usual, the servers aren't actually quite synced up, are they? The Winchester is not a good weapon. Not by any stretch of the imagination. It reloads slow. It's got good hitting speed, but it's got a very slow bolt. Very slow bolt. Painfully slow bolt. I wouldn't recommend you use it. I would not recommend you use it. It's not a good weapon. But, ooh, yeah, we've got a little, we've got a try-hard cat, we've got a real try-hard little seal clubber here, don't we? Fucking noob tubes in tier 2 and squads full of anti-personnel mines? Ooh, disgusting. The worst kind of human being. I do hate people who try. I really do. You shouldn't be allowed to try in video games. Seriously, video games would be so much better if nobody tried, ever. If people just played whatever was dumb and fun, video games would be so much better. And that is exactly what the Winchester is all about. It's dumb and fun. Because it makes you feel like a retarded cowboy in World War II. Is there a little PPSH here somewhere? No. Man, I feel so alone. Like, people who try aren't human, in my opinion. Like, seal clubbers are definitely not human. Like, the people who buy, like, the super premium vehicle in World of Tanks and then use that because the developers can't balance it because they already sold it, and so now they can't balance it because if they balance it, people will whinge, which, to be fair. You did buy a vehicle assuming it would actually be that vehicle and then just seal club voraciously. Those people are not human beings. They are not human beings. And they should be denied all, even the most basic human rights. Like, seriously. Like, if you get caught doing it, you should be put inside of the same kind of jail that we send the pedophiles to. Maybe that's even a little bit too comfortable. I don't know. I haven't thought about it yet. My full philosophy on the matter hasn't been worked out completely, but I'm working on it. Ooh, that was lucky. It makes you a worse human being. Like, actually, it makes your soul dark. Seriously. Now, of course, if there is actually punishment in the afterlife, then fair enough. You know? I can hear a spawn point. Of course, well, duh, I can hear a spawn point. There are people coming from over there. Duh. But... now, I want to go and find the spawn point to make their lives more difficult. I do enjoy a little bit of good old-fashioned bolt-action rifle every now and then. Okay, you, stay here. I'm going looking for the spawn point. There you are. Die, bitch, die. Oh, wow. Big cunt. Oh, definitely. Oh, yeah, I hope this person loses. I hope this person loses every match they're ever in. They deserve it. All of them. And that's why you use weapons like the Winchester. Because the Winchester just makes you feel like a fun little retarded cowboy. And who doesn't enjoy feeling like a fun little retarded cowboy, huh? Everybody. Everybody enjoys feeling like a dumb little cowboy. That's why Red Dead Redemption is so popular, because it lets you feel like a dumb little cowboy. Germans in the weeds. Nazis, if you will. It's Nazis if you must. Right, well, we are beating the absolute shit out of them, which is no less than they deserve, of course. They tried at video games. Nobody likes that. I would like it if I could shoot some more of them, though. Ooh, hell. Donk. See, this is why I want a nationalist Chinese tier. Just a tier where everybody has bolt-action rifles. That'd be really fun. The Mosin Nagant. More of a spear, originally, really, than a rifle. Unironically. It was unironically more of a spear than a fucking rifle. Goodbye, little German. The Mosin Nagant was originally developed to be very long and relatively heavy. Because the generals of the day, and by the way, now we're talking like late 1800s, very, very early, like 1900s, like pre-World War I stuff, right? Hi, I am very surprised you didn't kill me. Yep, I was kind of waiting for that to happen. Pre-1900 stuff, right? And was it 1870, I think, or something like that? The Soviet generals, well, Soviet, Russian generals at the time, they were of the opinion that the Russian soldier was not much for fanciful things like, you know, projectile weaponry or ranged weaponry. They figured that the humble Soviet soldier would be far more pleased running towards the enemy with a bayonet, screaming their little lungs off. And so they actually issued instructions to not fire the weapons on occasions. That the, what was it? The Russian soldier identifies with the bayonet. It suits his, was it spirit, I think they said? There's a whole scree about this. Which I always thought was quite cute. Obviously, the First World War taught the Russians many, many lessons about how spears were not actually the best weapons anymore. The age of the hoplite had passed. No, he died before I could kill him. Okay, admittedly, that was poorly aimed. Yay. A big fat musket, basically. Kill 100 enemies using a vehicle. What for? Oh, for the, No video game. I don't want your stupid armored fury pack. Go away. For that? Fair. 30 cosmetic orders? I'll take it. I don't actually have any machine guns in this squad, do I? Oh. And that pretty much remained the spirit of the Soviet and Russian army for quite some time. Though they did play around with semi-automatic rifles like the SVT, which wasn't bad. It was just too expensive. There was even a funny story where the Americans provided the Russians with some M1 Garands. The Soviets looked at it and thought, like, okay, this is pretty cute. Actually, we've got a rifle that fires, you know, bigger bullets and shit, so we're not really all that tickled. And it was too heavy. And that was one of the original reports as well. They were very impressed by the mechanical finesse of it all, because it was a very mechanically complex weapon. But the Russians decided it was too heavy for their soldiers, which I'm pretty sure was bullshit, by the way, because the Mosin was not exactly a light baby either. Ah, T-50. I see you've still got the double machine gun in the hull. Nice. Now. Come, little Germans. Send your little bodies onto me. Okay, I did get his firing ring with that. There you go, bitch. Oh, yeah, he's abandoned it. He's out. Oh. Okay. Was that? No, that was the game. I was wondering if that was my internet. Why, little Germans, why are you bouncing so energetically in front of my machine guns? How teasing, how tantalizing, how naughty. I can't seem to hit them. Ow. There's a tank over there somewhere, but he's hidden behind a house, so I'm not gonna need to worry about that. Oh, okay. Explosion pack. Ah, I'm flanked. Yeah. This thing is beat to shit. Is it worth repairing? Not really, but I'm pretty sure I get points for this. Why 450? I don't. Okay, well, I don't care. I hear a spawn point. Tank. I'm not gonna go mess with that. Really? No, bitch. Lying down there. This is the point at which I wish I had some sort of anti-tank, but I sorta do. Sorta. Care of that one. And the right. Wow, okay, you're a holy shit, boy, you're a flanking. Probably building a spawn point. Do I care? Little Winchester, Winchester. Winchester rhymes with Wincest. Not that that necessarily mean anything, mind you. It's just an observation, that's all. Just an observation. God, I love the little thing you do with it, the little schlang schlong. As you use its dumb little lever action. Oh, it's so adorable. It's so adorable. That's such a cute little weapon. Such an awful little weapon too, because it moves your aim every time you fire it. Which is really awful when it comes to, like, picking off multiple targets. Because it resets your aim every time, which... It really fucks with your brain. At least it fucks with mine. I keep forgetting where I'm aiming it. And I'm surprised every time when I bring up the sight and, like, is that where I was shooting? But it's still a beautiful weapon. Red Dead Redemption is a game that I wish I'd played more of, actually, in retrospect. Ugh. Stop milling about, you fucking AI shits. I'm trying to shoot you. Okay, they're all gonna come in here somewhere. Right about there, maybe? No, apparently not. Yeah. What? I don't know where that bullet went. Oh no, they're taking all of our points. Meh, not bothered. IL-2. The flying tank. This is the early version. I don't know why they gave the Soviets the early version for some reason. Oh, that was a lot of points they got back there. Jesus, that was a lot more points than I expected. I kind of gave up on that point because I figured like we'd already bled them enough, but if I'd known they'd get that much back, it probably would have followed. It'd been harder for it. So this one does not actually have a rear gunner, which is a pretty big deal, actually. Because you can make the rear gunner in this game. Yeah, I thought I heard an engine. BF-109 too, nice. Thought it was a Stuka there for a moment. The rear gunner is a big deal because you can actually make the rear gunner very accurate. Very, very accurate. Too accurate, probably, if I'm to be entirely honest with you. This is not a great place to be doing strafing runs, honestly. All enclosed in those goddamn buildings there. Not a great place for bombing runs at all. But even the early versions had quite a lot of armor. In fact, you can even see it on it. It also had armor plating on the bottom. The Germans gave the nickname the Flying Tank because it needed a lot of killing. A lot of killing. Now, a great deal of that was because the Germans, they didn't quite figure out where to aim on the IL-2, and this wasn't really even a German thing, this was a, like, all pilots thing, because all pilots, or most pilots anyways, were basically trained to shoot at the center mass of the aircraft to guarantee a hit, right? Because it's hard to hit an aircraft, believe it or not. And that meant that most of the bullets would hit the rear part right here, right? And there was actually, I think it was a 25 or 30 millimeter thick plate of steel right there. So if you were shooting at that, you wouldn't get through. Like, even 20 millimeter rounds would have a hard time getting through because, of course, you're shooting at a pretty thick plate of steel after your round has already lost almost all of its... Hello? Really? That didn't kill him? Huh. I felt like that was a really good hit, actually. There must have been a... Yeah, it must have been a wall or something in the way, because that was pretty slap-dang right on. Because, of course, even if it's a 20mm round, the thing is, you're shooting at something that's traveling at, like, 200, 300 kilometers per hour. So the kinetic energy of that round is going to be severely diminished by the time it actually hits something. And when it then hits 20, 30mm of steel on top of that, it's probably just going to bounce off. And anything smaller, like a 50 cal run around or a 7.7, had virtually no chance. And so you could pour a lot of ammo into the IL-2 for very little effect. Whereas if you shot at the wings, which did have some light armor plating, but they were a lot easier to destroy. Alternatively, one of the preferred tactics the Germans also developed was to attack from directly above, essentially trying to snipe out the pilots. I know. Oh, shit's down there somewhere. He's not firing now, though. Oh, there he is. What? Okay, he got on with a bomb. Was it? What, that, I got an assist. I felt like that. God, the drop on these missiles must be a lot more than I'm used to, because that was pretty a nice and clean approach. Oh well, I'll figure it out. Yay, bomb kills. Error, YouTube is not receiving enough video to maintain smooth streaming. No, well, it looks pretty smooth to me, video game. YouTube. Rock says not. I want you to know it's a Gundam is streaming right now and I still choose to watch you. Thank you very much. I should try and get It's a Gundam on the Archcast sometime. I've been recommended him several times. He does look like a nice guy. Got his career started over Fallout 76. Fallout 76 was one of those games whereby my principles got in the way again. Because I looked at it and I was like, yeah, this is going to be shit. Because it was always going to be shit. A multiplayer Fallout? What the fuck? No, obviously that's not going to work. Obviously that's going to be god-awful. There's simply no goddamn way in which that's going to be good. It ain't going to happen. And so I decided to just not talk about it at all. Because, like, yep, I've already made up my mind. I'm not even going to cover it. Should have. It was a huge thing. That game created entire careers. It's a Gundam was one of them. And it was a good thing, because he's a very good lad. Because Bethesda... People still believe that Bethesda was good at that point, which confused the fuck out of me, because I hated Fallout 4. I hated it. People keep telling me, like, Fallout 4 isn't that bad. It's actually a pretty good video game. And I look at it, and it's like, it's just Fallout 3. Reskinned. And released at full fucking price. The weapons are the same, the sound effects are the same, the enemies are the same. Like, Jesus, this isn't a new game, it's a full-price DLC pack. But I was told to shut up, like, no, you're just being silly. I said the same thing when they released Total War Warhammer 2. Like, don't buy it, it's a $60 piece of fucking DLC. People told me to shut up, they bought it. And now, finally people have arrived at my point of view. At long last, as always happens. It's like, wow, Total War Warhammer 3 is a fucking ripoff at this price. Yeah, isn't it just? Damn it. There's not a lot of Germans in the open, are there? I don't like that. There's too many buildings on this map. I don't like it. I'm not getting enough kills. I don't like it. There needs to be more open spaces where I can kill them mercilessly where they can't defend themselves. Jonathan Smith, have you ever watched Laserpig on T-34? Thoughts? I hear he's good, but I also know that he's a bit of a wokey, so kind of not. I know that because Artemis was actually talking to him and it was asked him if he wanted to come on the Archcast at some point. I was like, okay, that sounds cool. Because that was a guest idea presented by Artemis, basically, and said, okay, sure. And he was totally down for it, and then suddenly he stopped responding entirely to Artemis, apparently, and never spoke to him again. Presumably, he asked somebody, like, who's this Archfellow? Like, he's a fascist. Like, That always turns me off, people, when they stop talking to people because they hear about them. Like, that's usually not a great sign. Damn it, still no kills. Oh, yeah, I'm dead. That's a BF-109. Okay, wiggle waggle, make him overshoot, scissor the bitch. Oh boy, you overshot hard, didn't you, baby? Oh, you did. You overshot really bad. Let's see. Are you smart enough to just turn really, really hard? No, you're not. Oh, no, dude. Don't fucking try and run. Don't try to run from me. You're not that fast. You don't have that much energy. Oh, God, you should have just turned. Why didn't you just turn? Tard. Well, good for me, I guess. And the thing is, I'm not even casting any particular aspersions, you know, it's just, I've known people like that before, who is very friendly, until there's a whiff of controversy, and then they're very much so like, oh, no, I've never spoken to that guy, no, I disavow him fully, it's like, yeah. Mm. I don't like those kind of people. And I'm not even saying that he's one of them. I don't know him enough. It's just, it's one of those things that instinctively turn me off somebody really hard. Johnson Smith, have you ever watched today's video? Oh, no, I read that one. Go. That was the one I was talking about. God damn it. The Alzheimer is setting in again. Let's see. Is there anything worth shooting down here? Nah, it just died. Let me do a little of a low pass. Not bad, though. Well, let me see anything worth shooting down there. Well, everybody else is shooting at that, so... give the facade a little peppering. I got one guy. One guy is better than no guys. And see, this is the thing too, okay? A lot of you guys don't like Dev. And I understand. I really do. But no matter how wrong Dev is always willing to talk to people. And I am far more willing to humor someone who's willing to engage in the dialogue and is then hilariously, blatantly wrong than somebody who isn't. Like, Dev's a good guy. Dev's a very good guy. This is why I was always much more in favor of the right than the left in these days, too. Because I had my little exploratory arc. Exploratory arch. Ooh. That's almost clever, if it wasn't so cringeworthy. That's attack, I hope. Right, let's try and keep an eye on it. Let's try and kill the damn thing this time. Alright, these rockets drop off like nothing you'd fucking believe. I felt my fucking wing gently stroke against the facades of the building there, but I still have it, so that's good. Because I was actually contacting people on both the left and the right when I first started looking at what was happening in the world and wondering, like, is this going to be a problem? Like, is this whole, like, feminist stuff going to be an issue? Leftists never wanted to talk. Not a single one of them. Not a one. Not a single one. The right wingers, not a single one of them refused to talk. Not a one. It's like night and fucking day. And to be fair, this might not have as much to do with the political leanings of the people. It might simply have to do with the fact that one side was in the ascendancy and the other side was not. As of obviously, the winning side is going to be hesitant about communication because they have a lead to protect, you know? They have a situation standing to protect. Whereas the losing side, they don't really have that. For them, dialogue is almost nothing but a positive thing. It's a beneficial thing. It's a way to get their views out there when they're already being lambasted. There was a tank there, but I don't know if he's there anymore. Drop a couple of bombs, try not to break my wings off. Okay, yeah, he's there. Alright. Come in at a bit, more of an angle. Oh, okay, alright. Oh, I thought I cleared that. I apparently did not. Well, I suppose I was living on borrowed time at that point. Alright, let's go find some Germans to kill. What was that about? Oh, yes. Right versus left talkie-talkies. But still, it always gave me a much, much better impression of the right than the left. Oh yeah, that place is probably going to be literally crawling with God only knows how many fucking snipers in it. Because normally when you see people start to kind of stop attacking, that usually means that a considerable number of them have got themselves ensconced somewhere. Thank you. And are either sniping or in vehicles. Yeah. My machine gun now. Did you bring me another one? No, you didn't. Scoped car 98? Yeah, sure. Thank you. This isn't scoped. Oh. I was too worried about whether or not it was scoped to notice the guy next to me. Distraction is a terrible thing. I was about to say, the wind... Wait, no, this isn't a Winchester. This is a Mosin. Climb through the window. Hope nobody sees me. God, we got more tryhards, do we? Fuck. I do hate the introduction of the anti-infantry mines. Oh, damn, we managed to lose both of the points right there, didn't we? Yep. Because the anti-infantry mines is just like a way for you to pay to get some extra kills, in my opinion, which I'm not a massive fan of. Because there isn't actually any counter against them. That's the annoying part. They really need to introduce a talent that lets you spot mines. Now, 445 points. Wow. They do get a lot of points back, don't they? How the fuck did that miss? I am genuinely confused. Okay, that, not so confused. Oh, you little piece of shit AI. You yonky little bitch. You absolute yonky little bitch. Jonathan Smith, what are your thoughts on the T-34s? Under or overrated? Depends on their rating, I guess? I mean, in my opinion, the T-34 was probably the single best tank of the entire war. You know, in terms of its original design date, it wasn't the best tank overall, full stop. Obviously not. Although it kept pace very well. Like, the T-34-85 was still a competitive and competent tank, even at the very end of the war, which is very impressive. Very few other armored vehicles can claim the same. But at the starting date? Oh yeah, absolutely. The suspension system, the speed at which it was able to move, the gun, the armor, it outclassed every other vehicle at the time of its introduction. Every other vehicle. Like the only comparison you could make where it's like at least somewhat close-ish in a way would be with the French vehicles. Like the Char 1 Biz, for example, obviously had superior armor. And the various Renaults were not bad. In fact, the French tanks were really good. See, that's something else that a lot of people forget about. The French tanks were actually excellent. The Renault had a very good gun for the size of vehicle it was, of course. It had very good armor. It was slow as fuck and didn't have a radio. And it had a terrible crew compartment, which really undermined it drastically. Hello, little German. Is there going to be more of you over there? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, there's a whole parade of little schnapsies over in that direction. Where'd you go? Setting up spawn points. Oh, nice. That was a lucky grenade. That was a very, very, very lucky grenade. That was a very, very, very lucky grenade. I'm not even gonna pretend that was calculated. That was pure fucking luck. Pure unadulterated fucking luck. Oh. Not allowed to go over there. I'm sorry, Mr. Commissar. I didn't know I wasn't allowed to attack the Germans. I thought the point of the war was to assault the Germans. That's where you were wrong, silly little Soviet soldier. Uh-oh. Well, shit. Surprise! Right. Hi there. Yeah, that was not good. That was never gonna work out particularly well, but I felt I had to make the effort. Oh, switch soldier immediately. Switch quick. Oh, come the fuck. Shoot him, you tart! Shoot him! There you go. Fucking AI. Sometimes AI. Sometimes you are a dum-dum. The Winchester doesn't have a bayonet, which is actually a big deal. Like, I hate the fact that the Winchester doesn't have a bayonet. It should get a bayonet. Because since it doesn't have a bayonet, you can't bayonet charge with it. And bayonet charging is a surprisingly useful strategy when, you know, the enemy is about to... How the fuck did that miss? I am genuinely shocked and confused. Ah, damn it. In my rear. For example, right there, if I could have bayonet charged him, I would have, and I would have killed him very easily. Zarodina, bitches! Eat it. Wow, that didn't kill anybody? Really? The massive explosive pack to the fucking face didn't put you down? I feel like just the impact would have sent him sprawling, honestly. But apparently not. Uh-oh. Oh, that was lucky. All right. Oh, you bandaged quick, didn't you? Do you have anything cool for me? You've got a grenade launcher thing. How did you activate the grenade launcher again? I don't remember. I never use noob tubes. Oh, bitch. I never use noob tubes, and so when one was delivered onto my hands, I did not know how to use its ability to noob tube. Which one might argue could be quite tragic. Ah, I fired! Ah, got him. I hate it when you feel yourself press the trigger and no bullet comes out because on his screen he'd already shot your ass. And it just took a second for the server to catch up. This is not a very good SMG. I don't like the sounds it makes, though. Yeah. I stopped shooting him, because I was pretty sure, like, oh, he's dead, right? Nope. Oh, God. Okay, we're old-school bolt-action dueling here. I like it. I enjoy these bolt-action duels. I really do. They're a lot of fun. Just too bad that some bitch always has to bring a machine gun and ruin it all. Like, but I want to win the firefight. Yeah, but... That's not important. Winning the firefight is not the point. Doing so in style is. That is how it should be, and that is how it shall be. Ooh, little fucking shit. The world would be a much better place if everybody thought like me. If everybody thought like Arch, the world would be such a better place. Nobody does anything gay, and so the developers never put anything gay in the games because nobody likes gay. They just want bolt-action duels at medium range. That's all everybody wants. What? Oh, come on! I am pretty sure I hit you there, buddy. In fact, I'm pretty sure. Alright. How many more of that are you over here? I know there's more of you. I can smell your Hugo Boss all the way over here. A Wurksturmgewehr. Good. Help me. Wait. Semi-auto. Interesting. A semi-auto Wurksturm. He might just have it set to semi-auto, mind you. God, it fires like a pop can. Bit too much bullet bloom for my taste. A bit difficult to see what you're shooting at. Still, cute, if retarded. It wobbles over at the front. Oh, that's so dumb. I hate it. Oh, God. Oh. Wow. Why did the Germans make this? Who looked at the Luger doing the weird wobble over at the top and went, that needs to be on an SMG? Good. A victory for the Red Army. That was a good match. A nice, long, horrible, grindy, shooty match. Excellent. And that gets me the unlocked German half-track. I wanted that one, because it looks bloody overpowered. I am never going to get the 40... kill 40 enemies with the machine gun. It just ain't gonna happen. Alright, one more. Oh yes. On the topic of the T-34 again, another notable advantage that one's got to point out is also the fact that it was able to be produced en masse. Now, there's also a disadvantage, actually, because the T-34 really was way too advanced of a tank for the Soviet Union. The Soviet scientists could dream it up, but the Soviet worker wasn't really able to produce it. See, this is why the T-34 is almost always blatantly overpowered in most, like, shooter games it is in. Like in War Thunder, for example, the T-34 is kind of way too good. And that's why it needs to go up against stuff like Panzer IVs and long-barrel 75s and Panthers and shit. And why, again, the T-34-85 chassis can still be kept up against, like, Tigers and stuff and still be competitive. The issue was that whilst the design was excellent, the armor was excellent, the gun was excellent, its all-terrain capabilities and speed was excellent, very rarely did the T-34 in reality actually reach any of those specifications. Often, the hull was faulty and far more brittle than it should be. The wiring in the turret was often flawed, and in some cases a straight-up fucking fire hazard, which is mildly hilarious when you think about it. The gun, too, often had a lot of problems with its gun block, and the Soviet optics were massively inferior to the Germans. Not only would they break frequently or even get shaken loose in their mountings, they were just qualitatively worse in terms of being able to locate, range, and aim and shoot at a target. But due to the handy-dandy fact that none of these things are ever actually represented in-game, that's never a actual issue for the T-34, and so it usually feels significantly more good than what it should probably be. Come on, little mortars. Come on, little mortar bombs. Come on, little mortar bombs. Give daddy something. Yay! Eh, one kill, two assists. Or, wait, didn't I get the kill? But I saw the little skull. Aww. Ah, once more you disappoint me, Morta. Once more. Once more, you disappoint. There's also, okay, one of the interesting things as well is people often talk about, like, tanks, because the tanks are kawaii. Okay, this is fair enough. Tanks are kawaii. Is there a German up here? There isn't a German up here. Interesting. But what we should really be talking about when it comes to Soviets isn't tanks, it's artillery. The Soviet artillery was excellent. It probably was... Well, I didn't expect you to be over there now, did I? It probably was the best artillery arc. How? Oh, that wasn't a German. That was a piece of wood. It's easy to... Uh-oh. Yeah, probably dead. Yep. It is easy to mistake the two. Germans and pieces of... wood, that is. How? Okay, I... Oh, fuck me. I was shooting from the hip there, so there's always, like, a complete massive bloom on that. But, like, first shot, I was like, okay, that's gonna hit. Second shot, that's definitely gonna hit. Third shot, I see the impact on him, and then he kills me. Like, okay, server, hello there. Uh-oh. Yeah, that's a tank. This SMG has kind of awful damage. Alright. Are we winning? Sorta, kind of, in a way, yes. Okay, my AI is shooting into this bush, which probably means that there's somebody behind it somewhere. Right in the ass. Don't you dare go hide on the attic like some fucking woman, bitch. White phosphorus grenade. Oh, I'm sorry, Commissar. Once again, what was I thinking? Attacking the enemy. How silly of me. You, go there. Once again, my offensive spirit clearly got the best of me. Bad, Jim. It's bad. 13 bullets left. Not ideal. Especially not with aiming like that. Well. Hurrah! Damn it. Fucking AI! The AI heard me running, and so turned to kill me. Very infuriating. I was hoping that was a player, because players are unironically deafer than the AI is. Don't change between running and sprinting, you little shit. It makes it hard to hit. I don't like it when you do that. Oh. After killing enough of them, finally, they managed to see the kill camera to go and smoke me out. Oh well. I'll fly around a little bit again. The tank. Good. I'm almost certainly going to lose sight of him by the time I get there, though, so let's take a slightly longer turn and see if anybody's willing to provide some coordinates on something. All right. rockets are really bad at dealing with tanks. I should probably stop trying, honestly. I should just use the 50 kilogram bombs. I'm gonna need to plant them basically directly on top of them, but that's functional. The rockets, however, those felt like dead-on hits. In fact, I'm pretty sure they were dead-on hits because I saw his engine get damaged. And yet they didn't blow up. It's a bit sad. Then represent the king tower, their brittle low quality steel, and three times repaired pants force with mismatched parts. Well, see, that's the thing. You probably should, to a degree. I think there's an opportunity there to actually do both of those things, because there were absolutely a lot of errors in production on both sides. The lower grade steel that you mentioned for later Tiger 2s, for example, absolutely. But I do believe that that is more often than not already kind of the case. For example, in War Thunder, they have made it so that if you... I don't know if they've changed this. They could have. I hope they have. But it used to be the case, at least, that if you shot the transmission, which the Germans rather famously placed in front of their armored vehicle, both in the Panzer IV, III, and I think even Tiger, maybe. Was it Tiger? Maybe not Tiger. If you shot the transmission, it would catch the vehicle on fire. Now, this didn't make a whole lot of sense because there's very little, if any, in fact, evidence that this actually happened. And the Germans specifically placed the transmission in front of the vehicle to protect the crew. Not to mention, the transmission oil that was in it wasn't particularly flammable. There wasn't a whole lot of it either, so it seemed weird the vehicle would just catch on fire from getting shot in its transmission. Especially as that doesn't really happen to any of the other nation's vehicles. And eventually, Gaijin explained why. Apparently, they were using secret Russian documents detailing testers made against German tanks after the end of the war on firing ranges, where a vehicle, which had already been struck by multiple other weapon impacts, its transmission did catch fire after being shot at by a 152mm cannon from close range. And that was enough for Gaijin to be like, well, there you go. It totally catches fire when shot. I see. The whole Russian bias thing is more than just a meme, at least in certain games. Right. 20 minutes left. I guess I should make it the full 3 hours as usual. Before I fuck off to get myself some snacks. One more then. God. What was the other one? There was there was another one from the same set of secret documents, where they... What was it? I think it was that 152mm HE shell could penetrate the front armor of a Tiger, or something like that. And that was because in the secret documents, they literally wrote that they drove the vehicle up till the point where the tank gun touched the armor and then fired... And then they did manage to create a break in the armor. Like, some really, really weird shit. Like, anyone who's played War Thunder for any extent of time is going to know a couple oddities with that game's balancing model. Kind of reminds me how old Pistoliers used to do things. There was a time, pike and shot era, where Pistoliers became one of the mainstay cavalry formations where they used flintlock and wheellock pistols. This introduced a little bit of an arms race between, well, armor, duh, and the pistols themselves. A race that the armor was winning very handily for a very long time. I feel like the roof of whatever building is over there is probably going to make this somewhat pointless, but... I'll do a generous little smattering of... mortar bombs anyways. on the exceedingly off chance that one of them finds its way through a hole in the roof and kills a German. Where armor was winning very easily, actually. Shockproof cuirasses and even shockproof helmets were made, and they were made fairly readily available. This meant that pistols, trying to compete, needed to become longer, because they didn't really figure out how to make them more powerful yet, which would include the more rapidly burning powder, etc. So pistols became longer, because if the pistol was long enough, then instead of needing to penetrate the armor with actual power of the bullet or the explosion, you can actually just rest the pistol directly against the enemy's armor, flat against it, and pull the trigger. Which certainly did increase the penetrative powers by quite a bit, so that was a solution, and that was indeed used. It became commonly applied. Yeah, I was about to say I'm about to get shot, aren't I? It became commonly applicable doctrine for musketeers to do that, where instead of using their swords and lances, the pistol actually near completely replaced the lance, which, here's the problem. The lance was a cute weapon, and a lot of armies tried to use the lance far beyond the limits of its actual usefulness because it was a romantic weapon, you know, a medieval knight lance and all that, but... Thank you for popping back out again. The medieval knight's hand, but if a pistol couldn't penetrate the armor, a fucking wooden lance didn't stand a chance in hell. And so the wooden lances became incapable of actually breaking the armor of the enemy, which made them useless. Whereas the pistol, now that you had to literally touch the enemy, was still able to penetrate the armor, even if, again, it required you to literally touch it. We're actually losing that point. For some reason, I didn't expect that to be the case. I don't really want to run over the open to get to it either, honestly. Hi. I don't like being here. This is actually not as good a position as I thought it would be. I came over here expecting to kill Germans. Expecting to kill Germans that would be coming the other way. Instead, all of the Germans are over there. On the opposite side from me. Which doesn't help me or my team in the slightest. My hopes of crossing this street alive are very, very small, but we're gonna go for it. I lived! Right. No. You stay over there. Please stay over there. Oh god, I'm too far away from my dudes, aren't they? They're gonna start following. They're not gonna live. Oh, yep. And yeah, they decided to follow me. Toss in Mr. Grenade first. I followed Mr. Grenade in a little bit too early. Remember, Mr. Grenade should always enter the room before you do, but you should not follow Mr. Grenade so closely that Mr. Grenade ends up hurting you as well. If you do so, well then Mr. Grenade has sort of kind of failed at his job, and you have failed Mr. Grenade at your job. Was quite simply to toss Mr. Grenade into the room with sufficient time for you to follow. For as always, you must remember, once Mr. Grenade leaves your hands, he's neither yours nor anybody else's friend. Where are all the Germans? I was told there would be Germans. Of course. And then he steps on a mine and kills himself. I wish he could have done that just a little bit earlier. Nah, I'm not gonna fly here. This is another very, very close-in map, and flying probably won't be that useful. Instead, I'm going to suffer through the PPS-42 some more. This is a very bad gun, and I dislike it tremendously. I do not enjoy it. I do not enjoy its presence. I do not enjoy the sound it makes. I do not enjoy the damage it makes. I don't know. Do I have looks? It reminds me too much of the Sten gun, and the Sten gun is an abomination. One of the many, many crimes that the British people have hoisted upon the rest of us. They have no care or realization of just how fucking inhumane and terrible they are being. There are many things for which the British people justly deserve to be punished. Sten gun is one of them. And it's not going to do anything. Die. It should actually do something, though. Unironically, it should. See, the reason why Molotovs don't work anymore is because we've created really good engine filtration systems. As the reason why the Molotov worked in the first place was because of the air intake on the back of the engine. That's why you threw the Molotov onto the rear of the enemy vehicle. Ow. Because when you did that, the engine would actually suck the flames into the tank's engine. Which obviously was not a very good thing for the tank. It was a disastrous thing for the tank, in fact. And would... Uh-oh. Well, I didn't mean to do that, but I'm here now, I guess. Hi. Which would suck the flames into the tank's engine, which would then, of course, disable the tank. Obviously enough. That's a tank. At this point in the war, however, Molotovs would still absolutely be effective. Not as a... Don't scare me like that. Not as effective against German tanks, mind you, because the German tanks actually did have better filtration systems on their engines than the Russians did. But against stuff like the T-34, oh, yeah, absolutely. The Molotov should still definitely be effective. But I suppose it would be a little bit of a balance problem if the, you know, basic Molotov cocktail was able to knock out armored vehicles. I like how that guy just refused to dip back down into his tank again. Ah, I didn't see you there. All right, we're winning pretty nicely. Middle of the I exited the building in the middle of an artillery barrage. Less than ideal. And come with me, Mindkinder. We're hunting tanks. Boy. Okay, well, there's, just me left. That damaged that tank nicely, but it didn't actually kill it. Right, well, I can keep this one annoyed and nervous. Can't actually hurt it or anything, but I can keep it nervous and annoyed. Gave my squad the order there to attack it, but none of them seemed interested in throwing their bundle of grenades. Hey, what are you building? Thank you. Aw, there's more of you? Why? You'd made me such a nice toy. Sometimes people just don't have any manners. Well, I know where I'm going. I'm not going to let him have that cute thing all for himself. Okay, did you kill the tank? Yes, you did. Okay, don't need to go over there and deal with it then. I would much prefer it if we ended this fucking game mode now. I hate this game mode. I really, really, really hate this game mode. This is my least favorite game mode by quite some margin. Because it only ends when either the points have been exhausted or one side captures all of the objectives. Die. And my issue with that is that if the sides don't actually exhaust that up... Oh, there's people down there! Fuck. You filthy little shits. Time. Boom. Right. Ugh. Little fucking shit has really found himself a nasty little camping spot there, hasn't he? Because he can be covered by other people sitting on the other end, whilst he's sitting up there, just watching the stairs, which is the only way up. Or is it the only way up? Ah. Damn, this is a real SimCity motherfucker, huh? Okay, so he closed off the back way with barbed wire and a sandbag to get people to not go there. Oh. Whilst I was busy trying to flank the motherfucker. We won, so that's fine. These matches can go on forever, and I hate them. I hate them so much. I hate them so tremendously much. Like, literally, I've seen some of those matches take like an hour. Oh, you've... Right. And with that, then, I think I shall wrap it up for today. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. Thank you for your donations as well. And we'll see you all again probably tomorrow. We'll maybe do some more Lord of the Rings tomorrow. We'll maybe do that, yeah. Perhaps. As there is no D&D tomorrow because Sargon is busy. Until next time, have a good day.